Ralph Waldo Emerson first published his essay on compensation in 1841. In it, while exploring the concept of compensation, defined it as the universal law of cause and effect. He argued that everything in the universe is interconnected and nothing occurs without a corresponding effect, that every action is compensated for, either in the present time or in the future, and that even the smallest actions can have significant consequences. In effect, what he was saying is that you reap what you sow. Increase will only come to what you have that is small. Increase will never come to an empty hand. Welcome to Success Digest, where we discuss and analyze those ingredients and principles vital to becoming financially independent and live a glorious and fulfilled life. My name is Kayode Enraitan, the publisher of Success Digest video series and the CEO of Kenny's Consult Limited, a financial service firm that is based in London. Today, we are going to discuss on the topic, turning your lack to opulence. Lack stands for a state of being without or not having enough of something. Opulence means having great wealth or luxuriousness. Today, we are going to base our discussion on turning our lack to opulence and abundance. For in life, being born poor does not dictate that you are to die poor. I wrote a book which is very explicit on this topic titled Born Poor, Die Rich. Every one of us, upon reaching the age of reasoning, desire an opulent life to have in abundance and in surplus and not lacking in essential things of life. There's only one principle that governs turning your have-not to having in surplus, and that is, you must have something that needs to be increased to abundance and become opulent. It is not a sin to lack, for some are even born into it. We all come into this world naked, bringing no material item into the world, but it is a sin if you accept it as your fate and do nothing about it. What we acquire in the world are the things we build either by birth or by our effort based upon our ability and knowledge. It is therefore expedient that if you lack or in deficit of something, you have to go and acquire it if you need it. Whatever you acquire, even though it could be small at the beginning, is what shall become big. There is no other right way of turning your lack to opulence. Your first step is to pursue knowledge and, if necessary, go back to school. For increase will only come to what you have and not simply, will not come to empty heart. Our greatest enemy to achievement in life is the fear of the unknown. It paralyzes the nerve centers, thus affecting the circulation of the blood. This in turn paralyzes the muscular system, so that fear affects the entire being, body, brain, nerve, physical, mental, and muscular. To overcome fear, you have to be conscious of power. Please, I'm not talking of political power here, but power of ability to do, ability to create. Wisdom, strength, courage, and all harmonious conditions are the result of power. While on the other hand, every lack, limitation, adverse circumstances are the result of weakness. Weakness is simply absence of power. What is this mysterious master force which we call power? We do not know, but then neither do we know what electricity is. But we know that by conforming to the requirements of the law by which electricity is governed, it will be our obedient servant, lighting our homes, our cities, run our machineries in factories, and serve us in many useful capacities. And so it is with this vital force. Although we do not know what it is, but we do know that it is the primary force which manifests through living body, giving it the ability to do, and that by complying with the laws and principles by which it is governed, we can open ourselves to a more abundant inflow of this vital energy, and thus express the highest possible degree of mental, moral, and spiritual efficiency. Believe me, this is the sense of power that has ever been the distinguishing mark of genius. You too can develop it, and if you comply with its law and principles, You can achieve whatever you desire to achieve. This is how you turn your lack to opulence. Unfortunately, the same force or energy needed for destruction when used negatively is also what is needed for development when you use it positively. This is what a lot do not know. When they act against the law of nature, they cut themselves off from this vital force, the energy giving the power essential for development and increase in whatever endeavor they engage in life. At the introduction, I mentioned that Emerson defined the concept of compensation as the universal law of cause and effect. Every human experience is an effect. If we can ascertain the cause, we shall find out that this cause is one which can be consciously controlled. The subsequent effect or subsequent experience will be within our control also. By this, we come to realize that our goal in life will then be no longer be the football of fate. A man will no longer be the child of fortune, but a child of destiny. Fate and fortune will be controlled as readily as a captain controls his ship or an engineer controls his train. Our mistake is the mistake of misplaced priority. We ignore reality by placing importance on things that have no principle, things that have no vitality, no life. For example, we speak of knowledge and ignorance. But ignorance is but lack of knowledge and is therefore found to be simply a word to express the absence of knowledge. It has no principle of its own. Knowledge is reality and ignorance has no principle in itself. We find again the same law in the moral world. We speak of good and evil, but good is a reality, something tangible, while evil is found to be simply a negative condition, the absence of good. Evil has no principle, no vitality, and no life. We know this because it can always be destroyed by good. Just as truth destroys error and light destroys darkness, so evil vanishes when good appears. Please, pursue power and not symbol of power. Seek after honor, not fame. Look for wealth, not riches. Pursue servitude, not position. Symbols of power, symbols of fame, riches and leadership position cannot be retained unless earned. They turn to ashes as you obtain them, unless you get it with merit. Seek ye first the kingdom, and all other things shall be added. It's a mathematical, scientific, and spiritually correct principle. Unfortunately, most of us neglect the search for the kingdom, but we run after the added things, failing to realize that nothing can be added until the kingdom is found. Until we face reality in our lives and stop chasing shadows, obtaining opulence in life will be a mirage. There is no human endeavor or profession that does not have its own how to do, such as every product manufactured has its own manner of operation coming with it. This explains how to assemble and how to achieve the maximum benefits of the product. Ignore the manner and you render the product useless unless you have a previous knowledge of its operation. The same thing applies in the attainment of your opulence in life. Ignore the principle, ignore the laws, and you remain in perpetual lack all your life. To be informed is to be transformed. Lack of information leads to deformation. The scripture says that my people perish because of lack of knowledge. Information brings knowledge, and knowledge is power, giving you the enablement for abundance, for opulence. Yes, you can be whatever you want to be, but you must be before you can do. And you can do only to the extent to which you are, and you are what you know. Let me repeat this. You can be whatever you want to be, but you must be before you can do. And you can do only to the extent to which you are, and you are what you know. That is the sequence. What we need for opulence is the law of increasing returns. And I'm going to explain this. The farmer sowed a seed of wheat and through the law of increasing returns, reaped multiple seeds at harvest time. But by this law of increasing returns, man will perish because he could not make the soil produce sufficient food for his existence, nor will there be any gain by sowing a field of wheat if the harvest yield failed to return more than was shown. When we appropriate this law and learn how to apply it to the service that we render, to the extent that it may yield returns in excess and out of proportion to the effort that we put forth, we can turn our lack to opulence, our not enough to abundance. But we have to render the service first, seek the kingdom first, and obtain it. One Saturday afternoon, a lawyer whose office was on the same floor as the employer of a stenographer came into his office and asked if he knew where he could get a stenographer to do a work which he was compelled to finish that day. This stenographer told the lawyer that all stenographers have gone to the ball game and that he would have been gone had he called 5 minutes later, but that he would be glad to do the job as he could go to ball game any other day, since the work has to be done that present day. He did the work for him, and when asked how much the lawyer owed, he replied, about $10,000. I sound like it is him, but if it were for anybody else, he would charge nothing. The lawyer laughed and left. Little did the stenographer think when he made those remarks, he would ever be paid the $10,000 for that afternoon's work. But he got the $10,000 and more than the $10,000. 6 months later, after he had forgotten about the incident, the lawyer called on him again and asked how much salary he was receiving. When he told him, the lawyer said he was ready to pay him that $10,000, which he laughingly said he would charge him. As he did pay it to him that day, he gave him a job, $10,000 a year increase in salary. Not only that, the lawyer became the attorney general of the state and the stenographer became his personal assistant. Unconsciously, the stenographer had put the law of increasing returns to the work that he did that afternoon by giving up the bargain and rendering a service which was obviously rendered out of a desire to be helpful and not for the sake of a monetary consideration. Services that we render out of duty are generally paid for, but there are some services that we render out of privilege, and this has not paid for most of the time, but such surely return with higher dividends, not necessarily in monetary terms, but always with goodwill. A man without goodwill is as poor as a church rat, no matter how fat his bank account. Whereas, the man with abundant goodwill is a millionaire many times over, no matter how lean his bank account. Goodwill is an investment that always pays back higher dividends than the amount invested. Seek ye first the kingdom, and please, make sure you obtain it. All other things will surely be added. The dancer that dances without being aware that someone is watching dances best. This is just the tip of the iceberg for this topic, but time will not permit me to continue. Nevertheless, we offer a one-to-one discussion on this topic and all of my previous videos to those who are interested. Please feel free to contact us at Kenny Consult Limited and allow us to discuss with you more enlightenments and ingredients needed for becoming financially independent. We are the financial expert that specializes in financial management. We will invest your fund on financial instruments for you at the stock exchange and manage it for you thereafter. Let us continue to travel together on this journey of success through the path of wisdom. To be informed is to be transformed, and not to be informed is to be deformed. My name still remains Kayode Enraitun, and I can be reached on 074-2794-2000 or 079-5177-5255. Or better still, visit our website, kenny's consult limited.uk, kenny's consult limited.uk. If you are blessed by this video, please subscribe to it, share it, and like it. Also, please visit our blog on YouTube for more of our videos. Please enjoy your success.
Welcome to Success Digest, where you obtain ingredients for your financial abundance and financial wellness and be fully financially independent. Let us travel together on this, our journey of success, through the path of wisdom. To be informed is to be transformed. Not to be informed is to be deformed. Success Digest leads you to financial independence.